Hey guys, how are you all? My name is Harshit Dwivedi, friends, and I welcome you back to my video. So in this video, friends, I will be taking up the classification of banks in India. So before starting with this topic, friends, I would like to tell you that the Central Bank of India is RBI, Reserve Bank of India. Every country is having its own central bank, and similarly for India, it is Reserve Bank of India. So basically, this is the oversight, you know, the regulator of the whole banking sector in India, and it is basically that organization that formulates the monetary policy of India. Okay, now coming on to the bank classification, bank can be classified in two ways, you know, broadly in two ways. One way of classification is scheduled banks, non-scheduled banks. And one way of classification banks is commercial bank, cooperative bank. What's the difference between two? Cooperative banks are those banks that work on a no profit, no loss model. And commercial banks, basically they strictly work on the principle of profit making thing. Okay, in the cooperative bank, obviously the person who has taken loan is also a shareholder in it. But it's not the same in commercial bank. The commercial banks are strictly working on for making profits. Similarly, when we talk about the scheduled bank and non-scheduled bank, so basically what are scheduled banks, friends? There is one RBI Act of 1934. Through this RBI Act of 1934, RBI started its operations from 1st of April 1935. The Act is of RBI 1934. There is a second schedule in this RBI Act of 1934. And in this second schedule, those banks which are covered under the second schedule of RBI Act of 1934, they are basically known as scheduled banks. And those who are not covered, they are non-scheduled banks. Now, the exact difference between scheduled banks and non-scheduled banks have been explained by me in a separate video, friends. The link of that separate video is given below. Also, in this classification video of banks, friends, there are two banks. One is regional rural banks that I have covered in a totally separate video. And one is cooperative banks that I have also covered in a separate video. The link of all of these three videos is given in the description box below. And this video itself is in English, friends. If you want a Hindi version of the video, the link of that is also given below. So basically, all of these videos I have made in both English and Hindi. Okay, so this was scheduled bank, which finds a place in the second schedule of RBI Act of 1934. And also, for being qualified as a scheduled bank, you should have a minimum 5 lakh paid up capital. Minimum 5 lakh paid up capital. Now, what is paid up capital? Paid up capital means that whenever bank, you know, subscribes itself into, you know, the market, the share market. So basically, when the shares of a particular bank are sold in the primary market, so at least 5 lakh rupees worth of share should be purchased by the people outside of the bank. That is, at least shares worth rupees 5 lakhs should be holded by the public, by the outsiders in that particular bank. So this becomes 5 lakh rupees paid up capital. Don't worry, friends. Scheduled bank and non-scheduled bank. The difference between the scheduled bank and non-scheduled bank have been properly explained by me in a separate video. You watch that video, everything will be clear to you. One thing you should know, the basic difference is there are a lot of restrictions of RBI on scheduled banks, but those restrictions are not applicable to non-scheduled banks. Therefore, the area of operation of non-scheduled banks is restricted, but the area of operation of scheduled bank is very wide. Now, when we talk about commercial bank and cooperative bank, friends, scheduled bank consists of both commercial and cooperative. That is, some scheduled banks are scheduled commercial banks and some scheduled banks are scheduled cooperative banks. Okay, so basically cooperative and commercial both are there under the scheduled banks, and commercial and cooperative both are there under the non-scheduled banks. Okay, so this thing becomes clear to you. Now coming on to the next important thing, public sector banks. So basically, public sector banks, they operate more than 70% of the banking business of India. They include SBI, the nationalized bank, and the large public sector banks. What are the banks which are included in these public sector banks? So basically, in the public sector banks, banks like, you know, PNB, SBI, Dena Bank, Bank of Baroda, Allahabad Bank, Canara Bank, Syndicate Bank, UCO Bank, Corporation Bank, Central Bank, Andhra Bank, Oriental Bank of Commerce, IDBI Bank, and others. So these are the public sector banks, friends. You very well know about the public sector. Means the majority ownership of these banks lies with the government. The next in line comes the private sector banks. When we classify private sector banks, then two classification of private sector banks will come in front of us. One is old private sector banks and other is the new private sector banks, which are formed in 1993. What all banks are covered under these private sector banks? So basically it is HDFC, ICICI Bank, Yes Bank, Axis Bank, Federal Bank, South Indian Bank, and many other banks, Karur Vyasa Bank, then Catholic Syrian Bank. So these are the private sector banks which are operating in India, because the majority of it is not held by the government, they are held by the private shareholders. Many foreign banks are operating inside India also, Citibank, Standard Chartered Bank, HSBC Bank. Now, what's important about foreign sector banks, friend? See, foreign sector, the market share of these foreign banks is very less. The foreign banks work in India, but their headquarters is in a foreign country. So obviously, they work in the jurisdiction of not only the host country, but also the parent country. Also, the area of operation of foreign banks is very much limited. They are involved in niche areas only. For example, foreign banks deal with things like wealth management, investment banking, etc., etc. So basically, these are the type of niches in which these foreign banks are deployed. And in India, the foreign bank work on the principles of reciprocity. For example, those countries' foreign banks easily work inside India. In which countries Indian banks are allowed to work, you know, with a lot of freedom, without too much restrictions. So basically, those countries in which Indian banks are allowed to invest without restrictions, such countries' banks can also come to India and set up their branches. So basically, these foreign banks are, you know, set up in India on the basis of the principle of reciprocity, and there are certain limitations and restrictions also placed on RBI on these foreign banks, you know, in their area of operation. Next, we are going to talk about the small finance bank, friends. What are small finance bank? Small finance bank, you know, they cater to a niche segment, N-I-C-H-E. What is niche segment? That is, for example, they work for a particular area of operation. For example, they work for the financial inclusion of those areas which are not covered by regular and big banks, like unorganized sector. For example, the people, street vendors, then the laborers who are working in buildings, in homes, you know, the maids who are going into homes and working, you know, washing utensils and making food and washing cloths. So basically, these type of sectors, unorganized sectors, then small farmers are also assisted by small finance banks. Micro industries are also assisted by small finance banks, and these small finance banks are also under the regulatory supervision of Reserve Bank of India. Then next is payment bank. What is important about payment bank, friends? See, payment bank is basically a new model. It is still evolving. It is working on a small scale right now. What happens in a payment bank? In a payment bank, one customer can make a deposit of maximum 1 lakh rupees. Payment bank gives the, you know, facilities like net banking, credit card, debit card, all of these things, UPI, United Payment Interface, all of these facilities is given by payment bank. And payment bank is basically for making small payments. Like, for example, in rural areas, the workers who are working in the MNREGA scheme, their payment is made through these payment banks. So basically, small payments, especially they cater to the rural areas. Okay, there is a certain condition that this much amount of branches of payment bank has to be opened in rural areas. So on this principle, this payment banks operate. So two banks I have still not covered, friends. One is Cooperative Bank and one is Regional Rural Banks, which I will be covering in the upcoming videos. Also, friends, not too much technicality have been discussed by me in this video. This is a very basic video. Slowly, slowly, the technicalities will also evolve with the upcoming videos of economics. So thank you for watching this video, friends. If this video was helpful for you, kindly subscribe to my channel. Kindly share these videos on your social media handles, on Instagram, Facebook and other accounts. And thank you for watching this video, friends. Keep studying and have a good health.